Hey and welcome! My name is Tim and today I'm going to show you how to create your own high quality materials and maps for your planning projects. Well designed materials bring a design to life by simulating surface textures, colors and light effects. Especially with wood, fabrics or tiles, you can see the effect very well. In order for the materials to have their full effect in pCon.planner, you can attach texture layers to them. Today I will show you how to do that. pCon.planner uses the physically based rendering, short PBR, as its material model. To explain it briefly, a material can reflect light, refract it, or absorb it. These possibilities to interact with light are controlled by the material properties. If you want to know more about the material model, feel free to click the link in the description. The materials from the integrated material catalog are already optimized for the PBR model. But what about creating your own materials and adding textures? In the material editor, you can see an overview of all the materials in your project. With the plus button, you can create a new standard material. If you already know what kind of material you want to create, you can also use the small arrow to make a pre-selection, such as a wooden parquet. To create a proper base for the material, it is important to use high-resolution images as textures. You can find them on many places on the internet. Now add your texture to the material with the button on the right. Now you can simply drag and drop your material to the desired location. To get even more out of your materials, you have additional settings such as roughness or reflection. You can adjust the values with the sliders or add texture layers. These texture layers can be normal or roughness maps, giving your material even more structure. It is very easy to create these maps online, for example with the tool Normal Map Online. You can find the link in the video description. Simply drag and drop your texture into the field on the left. You will now see a preview of the normal map, which you can adjust and then download. Use the sliders to adjust the strength and intensity so that the texture of the material stands out well. For the parquet floor, the perimeters should not be too high so that the edges do not look too sharp. For the roughness and reflection, create a so-called specular map. I recommend that you create several versions until you get a good feel for the effect the perimeters make on the map. Returning back to pCon.planner, you can now insert the texture layer just like the texture itself using the button on the right of the property. Here you can now see how the material looks without texture layers and now how it looks with a normal and a specular map. Improve your materials with these simple tools to give your design a more professional look and increase confidence in your design. Also, feel free to check out our video with 5 tips for realistic renderings. If you have any questions about materials, feel free to post them in the comments. Thank you for your attention and see you next time.